Friends, today we discuss about 12th accountancy morning video. In this morning video, we continue the same chapter, accounts of not for profit organization. In the previous classes, we discuss about the various topics, that is meaning, definition, features, functions, importance of resident payment account and income and expense account, and also the specimen of resident payment account and income and expense account. And also we work out some problems in order to more understand the resident payment account and income and expenditure account. And also some of the example sums we discuss. And then today we discuss about the difference between resident payment account and income and expenditure account. Purpose: it is prepared to know the cash receipts and cash payments. So in order to prepare the resident payment account, the main purpose is to know the cash receipts and cash payments. But income and expenditure account, it is prepared to know whether there is an excess of income over expenditure, that is surplus, or an excess of expenditure over income, that is deficit, during the current period. That is, we understand and we know the difference between the income and expenditure, whether surplus or a deficit. So surplus means x of income over expenditure, deficit means x of expenditure over income. So in order to prepare the income and expenditure account, we know these two results. That is the main purpose of preparing income and expenditure account. Then nature of account. In the case of resident payment account, it is a real account and it is a summary of cash account. Cash receipts are recorded on the debit side and cash payments are recorded on the credit side. So all cash receipts and cash payments are to be recorded in the resident payment account. In the case of income and expense account, it is a nominal account and it is similar to profit and loss account. So the result will be excess of expense are recorded in the debit side and income are recorded in the credit side. The result we can arise while balancing the income and expenditure account. So in the case of income and expense account, we should record income on debit credit side, expenses on debit side, and it is just like as a profit and a loss account. Basis of accounting: it is based on cash system of accounting, that is resident payment account is based on cash system of accounting, and non-cash items are not recorded in the resident payment account. Only cash transaction should be recorded. And in the case of income and expense account, it is based on accrual system of accounting, that is non-cash item like outstanding expenses, depreciation, profit or loss on sale of assets, that should also be recorded in the income and expenditure account. So income and expense account should be based on the accrual system of accounting. Then opening and closing balance. In the case of resident payment account, it commences with opening and closing balances. So in the case of resident payment account, it commences with opening balance of cash and bank and ends with opening closing balance of cash and bank. So resident payment account will commence with opening cash and bank balance, ends with closing cash and bank balance. But in the case of income and expenditure account, there is no opening balance, but it will ends with surplus or deficit. Nature of items: in the case of resident payment account, it contains actual receipts and payments, irrespective of revenue or capital items in nature. So in the case of resident payment account, all receipts, all payments, whether it may be revenue or capital, that should be recorded in the resident payment account. But in the case of income and expenditure account, only revenue items should be taken, that is revenue income and revenue expenses, that should be taken to the income and expenditure account. Period of accounting: in the case of resident payment account, all cash receipts and payments made during the year pertaining to the past period, current period and a subsequent period are recorded. So in the case of receipt and payment account, all receipts and payment account, whether it may be a current year or previous year or next year, that should be received or paid. Current year means it should be taken to the receipt and payment account. But in the case of income and expense account, only current year amount that should be recorded in the income and expenditure account. That is, current year income and current year expenses should be recorded. Previous year and next year items will not be taken into account. Next, we should consider some of the items that should be treated as treatment of revenue receipts. Treatment of revenue receipts. That is, treatment of subscription in the final account of not-for-profit organization and treatment of income and expenditure account. That is, how subscription will be adjusted in final account of not-for-profit organization. When subscription received for the current year, previous year and subsequent year in given separately, subsidy received for the current year will be shown on the credit side of income and expenditure account, that is in income side. Account after making the adjustment, that is subscription outstanding for the current year is to be added. Subscription received in advance in the previous year, which is main for the current year, that also should be added because of current year income, that income. And after the totaling all these amount, when total subscription received during the current year is given, that total subscription is received during the current year will be shown on the credit side of income and expense account, making the following adjustment. That is, subscription outstanding in the previous year, which is received in the current year, will be subtracted. And subscription outstanding for the current year is added. And then subscription received in advance in the previous year, which is main for current year, is added. And subscription received in advance in the current year, which is main for the next year, will be subtracted. That is, subsequent year will be subtracted. So these adjustments should be made while recording the subscription in the income side of income and expenditure account. Balance sheet point of view, subscription outstanding for the current year and still outstanding for the previous year should be taken to the asset side of balance sheet. That is, current year outstanding subscription and previous year outstanding subscription, and also that subscription is current year outstanding, means it will be added to the balance sheet asset side. Subscription received in advance for the current year will be shown in the liability side of the balance sheet. So these are some of the important points to be noted in mind while dealing subscription in income and expenditure account. It is a specimen for income and expenditure account how the subscription will be adjusted. While preparing the income and expenditure account, I already told you, you should prepare income and expenditure account by using both the side of your account's notebook. That is, debit side and credit side. Left side is assumed as debit side, right side is assumed as credit side. So in the debit side, expenditure column should be maintained. In the credit side, income column should be maintained. So in the income side, subscription should be recorded. This subscription should be a total amount. So what the total amount of subscription received during the current year will be recorded first. So from that amount less subscription for the previous year, that is, previous year subscription is any given, means that should be subtracted. And then less subscription for the subsequent year, that is, next year subscription, subscription received in advance, that also should be subtracted. And then add outstanding subscription for the current year, so current year accrued subscription should be added. And then add received in advance subscription for the current year during the previous year. So current year subscription should be received advance in the previous year. That amount should be added. So totally four adjustments should be made in the subscription items in income and expenditure account. So in order to more understanding, we discuss some example sums in video 2. Thank you.